In this second part of the series, I'll describe the process of registering clinical trial information with ClinicalTrials.gov. Topics for this session include an overview of the scope and components of trials registered through the Protocol Registration and Results System, or PRS, for publication of trials on ClinicalTrials.gov, and key points to consider when providing information. ClinicalTrials.gov is a database for biomedical or health-related research in humans, and trials can be registered on the site if they conform with applicable human subjects protections or ethical review regulations, and if they conform with the applicable regulations of relevant health authorities. Prior to publication on the ClinicalTrials.gov website, trial information is first submitted via the Protocol Registration and Results System, or PRS, by manual entry or by upload. Entered information is evaluated via an automated system validation process. Records that have no errors via this analysis, which scans for missing or inconsistent information, can be released to ClinicalTrials.gov staff for review. Quality assurance staff, in turn, review submissions for apparent validity, meaningful entries, logic, internal consistency, and formatting, and publish records that fulfill review criteria to the ClinicalTrials.gov website. Records that do not pass this review and that have what are termed major problems are returned to data submitters with comments that must be addressed in order for those records to be published on ClinicalTrials.gov. Records must contain, at a minimum, descriptive information about the study, including the study type, for example, whether the study is interventional or observational, the phase, the study design, and the pre-specified outcome measures. Recruitment information, including the eligibility criteria and recruitment status, the sponsor name, the study locations and contact information for those interested in learning more about study participation, and administrative data such as the numbers used to identify the study, including any grant IDs or IDs assigned by other trial registries. Registered trial information must be kept up to date as the study progresses. Changes should be made as soon as practical to ensure that information is current and accurate. For example, when start and completion dates are firmly established, when the recruitment status changes, or when there are amendments to the protocol, these events are required to be reflected in the published record. All changes are tracked and archived on the ClinicalTrials.gov site. Registered trials include information about the study protocol, including a description of the study, conditions and keywords, details about the study design, the arms or groups and interventions being analyzed, and the pre-specified outcome measures. They also include recruitment information that clarifies the inclusion and exclusion criteria and the locations and context for the study. Additional information is included in modules that list sponsors and collaborators, oversight for the study, information to identify the study status and dates related to the progression of the study, a sharing statement for individual participant data, and a list of references relevant to the study. In response to requirements from the International Committee of Medical Journal Editors, data fields were added to the PRS for display on ClinicalTrials.gov that provide information about plans to share individual participant data stemming from a clinical trial. Manuscripts reporting results of clinical trials were required to include a data sharing statement as of July 1st, 2018. And trials enrolling participants on or after January 1st, 2019 were required to include the data sharing plan when registering the trial on clinicaltrials.gov. The ICMJE requirements also dictated that any changes to a registered sharing plan be reflected in the record published on clinicaltrials.gov and in the statement submitted and published with the manuscript. This is an overview of the IPD sharing statement module included in the protocol section of the PRS for publication of IPD sharing information on clinicaltrials.gov. The first plan to share IPD field allows the data submitter to indicate whether IPD will be made available. An open text field provides space for a description of the plan, including what specific data are to be shared. The data submitter can indicate the types of supporting information that will be included, for example, an analytic code to interpret the data as needed. A free text field for time frame allows the data submitter to indicate when the data will be made available and for how long. Finally, the access criteria and URL fields allow the data submitter to clarify with whom data will be shared, for what types of analyses, and by what mechanism. For example, if someone wishing to gain access to IPD needs to provide a research proposal for that access, that information can be included here. A separate IPD field is provided in the references module of the protocol section that allows data submitters to link to the supporting information documents they've identified in the IPD sharing statement module, as well as to the individual participant data set at the time those data become available. There are a number of key points to consider when registering trial information on clinicaltrials.gov, including understanding the distinction between interventional and observational trials, understanding what constitutes a single clinical trial, understanding the importance of the protocol in relation to registration, and being mindful of the need to keep the registered trial information up to date. In an interventional study, otherwise known as a clinical trial, participants are assigned to receive interventions according to a protocol because they are participating in the trial. Conversely, in an observational study, any interventions that participants might be receiving have been provided to them outside of the trial, for example, as a part of their routine care. Interventions are not assigned to participants as part of the study. Studies are considered interventional if participants would not have received an intervention were they not participating in the study, or if they are receiving an intervention in a different manner than they would were they not participating in the study. So, for example, diagnostic studies that use approved tests like a PET scan can be considered interventional studies if they meet these criteria. It can be difficult to determine whether a study should be listed separately or as a part of a larger study. For the purposes of reporting to clinicaltrials.gov, a trial is a single study if there is a single core protocol, regardless of how many study sites are participating. It is also a single study if there is an intent to combine and analyze the data in aggregate. Systems are in place at clinicaltrials.gov to detect registrations that duplicate information from the same core protocol. Follow-on studies should be considered a part of an initial trial and not registered separately if they are defined in the same protocol and include the same participants. However, they might qualify as separate if participants are required to reconsent to participation or if the participant population is different from the initial trial population. A study protocol is a research plan that pre-specifies hypotheses and the variables used to explore those hypotheses. The validity of conclusions drawn from a study depends on adherence to the pre-specified methods and analyses. Registration of protocol information for a trial with a database like clinicaltrials.gov is therefore vital in allowing for the comparison of reported results with the pre-specified study plan. Finally, it is vital to keep information up to date on clinicaltrials.gov so that potential participants can determine if it's possible to enroll in a trial and so that any valid changes to the pre-specified analyses are documented. Relevant fields include the recruitment status, the start and completion dates, and the registered outcome measures. All changes to a record are tracked on clinicaltrials.gov, so if a trial evolves to take a different course, the evolution of the study is transparent. In summary, the minimum components of a clinicaltrials.gov registration include descriptive information, recruitment information, location and contact information, and administrative data. It is imperative that changes to a study over time be documented on clinicaltrials.gov and that trial information be represented as accurately as possible. Now I'll ask a couple of questions to review the material that we've covered. True or false? Once a trial is registered with clinicaltrials.gov, no further updates to a study record are required until it is time to report results. This is false. There are certain fields that must be updated in a timely fashion prior to results reporting so that the status of the trial is clear to potential participants and to other interested parties. True or false? Registration of a trial on clinicaltrials.gov allows for comparison of protocol information with journal publications that report results. This is true. Faithful registration of pre-specified outcome measures facilitates the interpretation of what is ultimately reported in the literature. I hope you've learned about the importance of timely and accurate trial registration with registries like ClinicalTrials.gov. Thank you for your attention.